which of these two theoretical structures should be the front runner is a bit of a difficult question, not simply because it depends on where you're coming from. I mean, if you're trained as a particle theorist, the tendency would be for you to favour string theory as the best approach. But if you're perhaps trained or your thinking is more biased perhaps towards relativity, then you might tend to favour loop quantum gravity. But it's not as simple as you know, a kind of tribalism amongst the community of theoretical physicists as that tends to suggest. For me, I think it really does depend on what I would think of as your kind of metaphysical preconception or precondition. How do you think the universe should be? And if you think in the universe, space-time should be emergent, then there's a sense in which loop quantum gravity ought to be the theory for you. If you are not so concerned about whether space and time are real or absolute or relative, then to a certain extent, you know, maybe the particle approach, the string theory approach is more favorable. It depends on where you're coming from. It's been interesting in writing this book. I've talked to many theorists, all with differing views. This is very difficult to get any kind of consensus in the community of theoretical physicists at the moment. But there's a sense in which string theory is favoured because it's mathematically more rigorous and consistent. And that's fine. If your preconception or your precondition is for mathematical rigor and consistency, then yeah, I can see why string theory would be attractive. On the other hand, if you look back at the way that theoretical discoveries have been made in science kind of almost throughout the ages, I think on balance you'll find that physical intuition proved to be a firmer guide than mathematical rigor and consistency. So for me, string theory might be rigorous, but it leads me to have to believe six impossible things before breakfast, like the idea of six spatial hidden dimensions, the idea of a compactification of these hidden dimensions, of which different views suggest that there could be 10 to the power 500 or an infinite number of different ways of doing this, which leads to the idea that, okay, maybe there's the only unique thing about our universe, it happens to be a compactification scheme that gives rise to the physical laws that we know and the spectrum of particles that we know. So I have to believe a lot of really difficult physical things if I accept the rigor and consistency of string theory. Whereas with something like loop quantum gravity, it might be somewhat less rigorous, somewhat less consistent in its structure, but physically, I find it more intuitive.